Hey everyone, here we are ready to make IMO 5. IMO 5 is the concept of using your biologically rich IMO number 4 and adding a fertilizer, a nitrogen source or some kind of material for composting. So today what we're going to show you is IMO 5 using the same nutrients we made IMO 4 with, and this, which is a super nitrogen rich material left over from the production of black soldier fly larvae, which we can talk about later, but those are used for animal feed, chicken feed, etc., a cheap food source. But the material left over when making or producing black soldier fly larvae is super nitrogen rich. So by itself, it can go anaerobic and get kind of ammonia smelling. So mixing it with your big, strong microbes, you can get the use of all that nitrogen ready to go for plant production. So today, first things first, we have our water. This is somewhat wet, so we're going to add it to our dry IMO4, but we don't need as much water as if we had dry material and dry material. So we're going to use our water amount's going to be based kind of on this amount of dry material, as that doesn't really need any more moisture. So kind of like when we made IMO4, it's about 100 something pounds, approximately, we'll say. And so we're going to need about approximately, 5 gallons. I'm thinking about 4, so I have 4 gallons here. We'll see how that comes out. We'll check our moisture once we mix and add our nutrients. So first things first, add your nutrients to the water. Here's my humic acid. For about 4 gallons, we're going to use about an ounce. Got my nice little 1 ounce cup. 1 ounce humic acid. 1 ounce FPJ. It's a little active when capped. Banana flour FPJ is what I'm using today. So when I'm using 1 ounce to 4 gallons, I'm using a ratio of 1 to 500, approximately. The humic acid, we could use less or more depending on the source of humic acid. Check that out in some of the other IMO videos. We're going to get 1 ounce of brown rice vinegar, again a 1 to 500 ratio. And OHN is about, this 3-year-old OHN, which adds a level of complexity, but OHN, you're gonna have about 4 ounces, or 0.4 ounces for this amount. Seawater's 30 ounces. And you can use more seawater, a little bit more if you want. So I have ounce marks on here, so I'm gonna use about 30 ounces of seawater. Looks good. Like I said, a little bit extra seawater is fine for those extra minerals. Stir it all together, and your nutrient water is ready to go. This material has been in the bin. It was stored with its lid on, so it is starting to get a little bit of an ammonia smell. It's, again, crazy high in nitrogen and wet. So hopefully we calm this down and get it kind of activated by our IMO4. That ammonia smell in a wet high nitrogen material is caused by an actinobacteria, usually or often. So that ammonia smell is happening in your production of biology, you probably went anaerobic. Not the end of the world, but the quality drops because you start off-gassing all your nitrogen instead of trapping it in biology or fungal spores or fungal bodies. All right, so here we are. Similar amounts. This ratio here, you're gonna have to play with depending on what you're using. If you're using manure or whatever, food waste, you're gonna have to figure out how much of this material to how much this material finishes off properly. This is gonna be trial and error for you guys. And I'm sorry I can't tell you in every situation right here on the video, but I'm gonna give you some rules of thumb and some ideas of how this works. But what's nice is your IMO4 can treat your high nitrogen materials like manure and finish it very quickly. So let's get the materials mixed and get our moisture right. I'm gonna start the mixing dry, and that's because getting the moisture evenly distributed and is hard enough. Having some of the material kind of equally distributed throughout the pile ahead of time before I start adding in the moisture helps me get the moisture right and get it mixed properly. So I mix a little bit first. It's a little extra work, but in the end, you got a better distribution of both your materials together and your moisture or nutrient. So we're done mixing, and again, I put that kind of divot in the middle so that we have a place to pour our liquid and kind of fold our dry material into. It just helps with keeping the water from running off all the sides. All right. So again, you can always add more liquid as you go. You can't take liquid out. So be careful that you don't dump it all in and then decide you have too much moisture, because then you gotta go find dry material to add to your pile, and that can be a hassle. So start slow, mix thoroughly, and add as you need. But once you get a feel for this, you'll really know how much moisture you need to get your pile to the right spot. And you'll have less of the trial and error or slowly adding. So I mixed about half my moisture in, evenly distributed, and now I'm gonna add the other half. The material, the IMO, was pretty dry, so we are experiencing this is not quite to moisture yet. We'll see after the other half, but we may need another gallon or so. Back to it. I highly recommend doing this with friends. It's much more fun. Terry, you want to jump in and join me here? With IMO5, there's so much nitrogen that it's really important not to get too wet. You can handle a little bit of extra moisture with IMO3 maybe. With IMO5, if you get too wet because of all that nitrogen, you're really gonna get kind of blasted in temperature. Your temperature's gonna spike and it might be hard to control. So if you're using high nitrogen, especially manures or anything like that, be careful that you keep your moisture low and let the microbes do the work. So we mixed in that moisture, that 4 gallons of moisture, and we've come to this. And we're in a somewhat dry location, so we're almost too dry. We're almost perfect too. And what I want to do is really stress again, especially with IMO5 and your nitrogen, going too wet is really going to hurt you. You'll have a high temperature spike, like 130, 140 degrees Fahrenheit. And especially with that high nitrogen material. So right now we're not going for squeezing of moisture between my fingers. I'm kind of going for a snowball or a clod of dirt that I can kind of squeeze because of the moisture and then break apart. It's kind of hard to express to you this moisture exactly. But it has moisture, but it's not sopping wet. And so what that'll do with this high nitrogen material is it'll enable that oxygen to be kind of permeated a little bit into the layer of it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna leave this just like the other IMOs, IMO 3 and 4, and turn it daily, and we'll get a temperature, and we'll get it heating up, and it'll process all that nitrogen into microbial bodies, and we'll spread this in our garden patch in about a week. Thanks for watching, guys. This is IMO5. You can make it with all sorts of things. It's IMO4 plus a fertilizer or nitrogen source. See you later.